Hello and welcome back to my channel. This week we are keeping it a little lighthearted. We've been doing a lot of procurement and billing, and this week what we're going to do is just keep it into some tips and tricks that I know about ConnectWise, which I found out a lot of my clients didn't know this week. And there's no point in me knowing and you not knowing. So here are some of my favorite tips and tricks within the ConnectWise PSA, formerly ConnectWise Manage System. When you are going through this system, the first thing I want to call to your attention is that anything in the system that has a little dog ear in this upper right-hand corner, and I'm going to zoom all the way in so you can see it, anything that has this little dog ear is editable from the screen you are on. What do I mean by this? Well, if we are in the status section of the My Opportunities and I see this little dog ear, I can right click and that's going to give me the drop down of what these statuses are directly from this screen. So I don't need to go in and click every single one, go into every opportunity and change it. I can change it from here. So I can go ahead and hit no decision, and it will prompt me and bring me to the next screen. This is true for everything that's dog-eared. So let's go over and look at some other ones. Close date, very helpful. If I needed to push this out, I could right click and I can say this is going to close in about a month. So let's say plus 1 month. That's gonna go plus 1 month from today. And I can easily go through and update all of my opportunities like this very quickly without clicking into any one of them individually. Amazing. As you can tell, I spent a lot of time this week cleaning up opportunities. Next up, if you are in one of the opportunities, anything underlined is clickable. What do I mean by that? Well, if something is underlined here or here, this is a clickable record. So if I were to click where it says company and underlined, it's going to open up the company profile for Blue Web. So if I click on that company, this is going to pop up and give me that information right away. This is so incredibly helpful. I get feedback that sometimes I navigate through the system too quickly and it's hard for people to follow along. If you also want to frustrate all your peers, you too can click too quickly through the system by clicking the underlined sections to get exactly where you want and then follow the breadcrumbs back to where you started. So if you don't want to hit back a number of times, you don't have to. If you have gone through and clicked all this information and you are all of a sudden quite far down the rabbit hole, you can go back and select where you want to be, which is in the opportunity, and that's going to bring you back without having to hit all those back buttons. This underlined, it's okay if the record is closed. So if you're in an invoice that has already been closed, and I'll show you what that means. If I'm in an invoice and everything has already been closed, it's all going to be grayed out. So see how everything here is all grayed out? It's because this billing status is closed and this invoice is closed. That does not take away from the underlying click functionality. This is still active, so you can still click company and bring up that record. I didn't know that. I'm a rule follower. I thought that it had to be all, it couldn't be grayed out, but it's okay if it's grayed out. It's still going to bring you to the right place. Extremely helpful. The last two things are that if there is a little link right here, if you ever see anything with a hyperlink, selecting that link is going to take you to that website. Goes into is incredible. I didn't intend to show up here, but they're great. And so that's going to bring you into that website. Next and last is the map functionality. If you are in a service ticket, and we're just going to open up a service ticket in here, there is a little location section, and you're going to have all this information in regards to the address and the site. This little map button is Google Maps. So if you click on it, it's going to open up that address in Google Maps. This, as you can imagine, is very helpful, especially if you're driving somewhere and you need to get to that site. This also works in the phone, in the app. So if you're in the ConnectWise app and you have the address filled out and you hit that little map button, it's going to open up Google Maps and it will show that address and location. That's it for this week. Just a quick one, but please make sure that you are checking out some of the other things that you can do in ConnectWise. Don't be too afraid to click some things. You know, your permission should be set up, we hope, but it is good to test out the underlined and see where you can get, and also try breadcrumbing back as well. If you have tips or tricks, please let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to do another video of this. Thanks.